Good morning, children. Today we are starting the new chapter, our environment from class 10. You have already studied about the environment in class 9. What is the definition of environment? Environment is the surrounding which consists of living and non-living components. Or we can also define the environment as the immediate surrounding of the organisms which consists of living and non-living components. The living components are called biotic component and non-living components abiotic components. The environment is changing every now and then due to human activity. The human activities pollute the environment. A large amount of waste materials, the heaps of the waste materials are being deposited and being dumped everywhere around the villages and even in the cities. So the waste disposal, how to control the waste generation, how to make our environment getting protected from or free of this waste material is the matter of concern these days. So dear children, today we would be asking certain questions and finding the answer to this. As the environment is the immediate surrounding of an organism which consists of the living and non-living or biotic and abiotic component, we must study the structure of the environment. You know, the environment consists of different layers or spheres. We can see hydrosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere, stratosphere, troposphere. All these are the different spheres you have studied in class 9. But let me come to the components of the air. Air consists of around 78% is nitrogen, 21% is oxygen, and 0.03% is carbon dioxide. You know that. But this is not the matter. You know, the waste which is generated day by day due to human activities is being dumped, and it becomes the heaps of waste getting dumped, getting increased day after or day by day. And how can we control it? What happens when we add waste to the environment? What happens when we add waste to the environment? You know, when we add waste to the environment, it can undergo certain changes. It can be degraded by the enzymes produced by bacteria and fungi. Such substances which can be degraded or broken down by the enzymes produced by bacteria and fungi are called biodegradable substances. So in short, we can say biodegradable substances are plant or animal origin, means it is organic in nature, like carbohydrates, protein, fats, liquids. All these are biodegradable substances, cellulose. So plants and animals' body, the body of microorganisms, all these are made of organic material such as carbohydrates, proteins, fats and nucleic acids. All these substances can be easily broken down by the enzymes produced by the bacteria and fungi. Such substances which can be broken down by the action of the enzymes produced by bacteria and fungi are called biodegradable substances. Then there will be a question, what are enzymes? Yes, of course you know, enzymes are biocatalysts that control the chemical reaction. Biocatalysts that control the chemical reaction. Only the living bodies, living things generate or produce the enzymes. So enzymes break down in our body, inside our digestive system, the enzymes break down the complex organic substances into simpler forms. Okay, that is the story of the past. You have studied in class 10 in the beginning. I mean, in the life process, I discovered about it. But now, the biodegradable substances are very clear. It is the organic substances present in plants and animals, or even in the dead bodies, which are produced degraded by the enzymes produced by the bacteria and fungi are called biodegradable substances. And at the same time, non-biodegradable substances are known organic in nature. They cannot be broken down by the action of the enzymes produced by the bacteria and fungi. They will remain in the soil. For example, plastic, glass, broken glasses or glasses, metals, all these substances, known biodegradable pesticides and chemicals like DDT. DDT cannot be biodegraded by the enzymes. And many such substances which are not organic in nature cannot be broken down, cannot be decomposed by the enzymes produced by the bacteria and fungi. Such substances are called non-biodegradable substances. So now you know the first question: why are certain substances are biodegradable and some other substances are not biodegradable? Substances which are organic in nature, organic means derived from plants and animals, or dead bodies of plants and animals, which can be broken down by the enzymes produced by microbes such as bacteria and fungi, are called biodegradable substances. And those substances which are non-organic, or we can say inorganic in nature, which are not present in the bodies of the plants and animals, cannot be broken down, cannot be decomposed by the enzyme produced by the bacteria and fungi. Such substances we can say non-biodegradable substances. Yes, of course, this is the first question. And we are coming to the second question of the index. You must understand that both biodegradable and non-biodegradable substances affect the environment harmfully. So let us think about two ways in which biodegradable substances would affect the environment. Give two ways. When we think about biodegradable substances, okay, they can be decomposed at the deposit, and the minerals present in the organic waste get mixed with the soil, and the plants take up it once again. The plants absorb these minerals and they utilize this. So that is the advantage of this the biodegradable substances. So biodegradable substances, when we decompose the minerals or the elements present in this, nutrients present in this, may dissolve with water and in the soil, and the plants can absorb it again for synthesis of various substances. So thereby, this decomposition of the organic material or biodegradable substances helps in the recycling of the nutrients in the nature. But inorganic substances being non-biodegradable, like plastic, glass, metals, and chemicals, non-biodegradable chemicals, they cannot be broken down and they remain in the soil and they harmfully affect the ecological balance. Now we can understand the main important point: what are the two ways by which biodegradable substances affect the environment? Yes, of course, the first one. Biodegradable substances emit very hard and foul smell, which make the life of humans and other organisms miserable. That is the first harmful effect of biodegradable substances. You know, biodegradable substances decompose the bad smell or foul odor generate, and that make our life miserable. That is the first one. Now, second one, we can say, when the biodegradable substances decompose, this area becomes the place for the breeding of flies. breeding of flies, like mosquitoes, house flies, Aedes flies, tsetse flies, and many types of flies will breed in this biodegradable waste, and they spread various disease causing pathogens and spread the diseases like cholera, typhoid, then diarrhea, tuberculosis. All these diseases can be spread through the flies, even malaria. Okay, you can see filariasis, chikungunya, all this can be spread by mosquitoes and various flies. So what are the two ways by which biodegradable substances affect the environment? First one, we can say, when biodegradable substances decompose, a foul smell generate, that is very bad smell, and make the life miserable. Okay, second, when the biodegradable substance decompose, it becomes the breeding ground for the flies, like mosquitoes, house flies. There are various types of flies, tsetse fly, Aedes fly, then many other types of flies that carry the germs from place to place and cause communicable diseases, infectious diseases such as cholera, typhoid, dysentery, diarrhea, and even tuberculosis. So we got this one. Now the next important one: what are the two ways by which non-biodegradable substances would affect the environment? Yes, the non-biodegradable substances affect the environment in many ways. Some of the non-biodegradable substances like DDT. Non-biodegradable substances like DDT. DDT is banned in our country, partially banned, in limited quantity, but in America and other countries it is totally banned. What is DDT? Dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethylene, which is non-biodegradable chemical. And many other endrin, marathion, they are partially degradable. Okay? So the non-biodegradable substances, chemicals such as DDT, they deposited the first harmful effect. Such a non-biodegradable substances would remain in the soil. Plants absorb it and it enters the food chain. And the human being occupy the last of the trophic level in a food chain. It will accumulate in the body of the humans and other organisms like fishes, birds, and humans. So such a way, the non-biodegradable substances like DDT enter the food chain and get accumulated progressively. This progressive accumulation of these non-biodegradable substances through the food chain is called biomagnification. So what is biomagnification? Yes, you know that. Biomagnification is the process whereby non-biodegradable substances such as DDT enter the food chain and get progressively accumulated in various food chain, trophic levels like fishes, birds, and humans. Being human in the last position in the last trophic level in a food chain, it will get to harmfully affect the humans. Oh, this progressive accumulation of the non-biodegradable substances in food chain is called biomagnification. So you already know this is the first harmful effect of the non-biodegradable substances. Now, another important thing: non-biodegradable substances like DDT and many other chemicals get deposited in the soil and will remain there for a long time. When the rainwater comes, they may be carried away to the water bodies, and it affects the water bodies and aquatic organisms. So fish get poisoned, aquatic animals get poisoned and die in large number. So the soil fertility will be lost, it will pollute the water bodies, and also it will kill the aquatic organisms. So this is all the introduction about this chapter. Thank you.